Okay, all right. Now this is this one. I don't know. I'm having a mild fret over the artists being lost. And as each generation ensues further into the future, we need to think what we're producing, where we are from here to 50 years from now. What are we producing? Now, all right, let's say one artist per 10 persons allow, as has been pretty much the norm, I think so, going on. I'm not seeing a great expoundant of this society. I'm not seeing a great bunch of poets, I'm not seeing a great bunch of writers, I'm not seeing a great bunch of intelligence in that direction. I'm seeing that part of the brain with each generation shrinking and shrinking and shrinking. So the opposite is true. We need, instead of having the one out of the 10 artists per person allowed, we need to kick it up. We have to kick it up majorly. So now the reason I'm saying this is because our brain here, this is brain function, you know. You teach it, and you teach it. One spot. Then you have the little generation of your children. And their little brains are like, oh yes, I'm like a little Houdini, just like my father. Okay, because it's been taught and taught and taught, again and again. Another Houdini. Now, when you stop the teaching, take it out of the schools. When you stop the teaching, you don't have the art fair every Saturday. When you stop the teaching, oh my gosh, who are we? What's gonna go on? Who are we, really? Without that sector of the brain being maximized, fulfilled, expounded upon, increased, who are we? Who are we gonna be? We're going to be the lineup conformist droids? Is that who we're going to be? Everybody, do you have your dress code? Do you have your dress code? It gets scary. It gets really scary when we stop training. And yes, it's a manipulation and experimenting and an expansion and a growth. It is a growth section because it is an enlargement of intelligence in that one sector. When you stop it and you shrink it, generation after generation after generation. Scary. I'm scared. I don't want to come back. I do not want to come back. It's just become too risky. Way too risky. So, to increase, how are we going to do this? Okay, I will already institute a process of, I don't know. Yeah, more and more and more on display. And even if it tires and bores you, it's like, oh my gosh, somebody else's little dog there, you know, on the painting, somebody's little cat, or some horse over there, or oh my gosh, not another desert scene. I don't care. It's not the worry. The worry is if it's not there. Because then you lose your poetic choice. You lose it. All right. And yeah. Oh my gosh. I feel as if I'm already there. in that lost poetic choice. I feel I'm already there in that lost artist allow, that increase in obsession, the have to, the must. I feel already damned by the others. It is scary, and you already know this. You go into the interior of America, it is a scary situation. It's very difficult for artists to even flounder. Yeah. So touche to all of you here at the coast to think you've got it all and it's easy. You go inside this America, you're not even as good as a migrant worker who just snuck across from Mexico. You are lower than them. You're garbage. So remember the fight we have here in America. And it is called no dress codes, ever. I don't endorse Catholicism and girls' schools. All right. Anyway, yeah, it's all in the same caboodle. Dress codes and the consciousness of art allow in the brain. Which side are you on? The shrunken one or the one that is intelligent?